Hailed as one of the most advanced barreled artillery systems in the world, the RCH-155 by the KNDS Group is a fairly new self-propelled indirect fire weapon. Using a 155mm L52 PzH 2000 gun, the RCH-155 sits atop an 8x8 Boxer wheeled armoured vehicle. So, what's so special about this weapon? What distinguishes it from other wheeled self-propelled artillery platforms like the French Caesar or Swedish Archer? We take a look in today's video. The technology that forms the RCH-155 goes back to the early 2000s with the AGM, or Artillery Gun Module. Designed by Krauss Maffei Wiegmann, or KMW, the AGM is based on technology used in the PzH 2000. The Boxer-based weapon that we know today as the RCH-155, with RCH standing for Remote Controlled Howitzer, was announced in 2014. The concept was shown at the Eurosatory Military Exhibition event in June 2014. According to Shepard Media, it was the first public appearance of the AGM-configured Boxer. In addition to the fully automatic turret armed with the 155mm gun, there was a 50 cal heavy machine gun, which was designed to be easily transferred between different carriers. Over the past decade, makers of the RCH-155 have continued to refine the system, and so here are the most notable features in its most current form. The RCH-155 offers large ammunition stowage and rapid replenishment. It's equipped with an autoloader for projectiles and charges. As you can see by this graphic, it is capable of what is known as MRSI, or Multiple Round Simultaneous Impact. And finally, navigation and fire control are autonomous. It also has a stable weapons platform that enables firing in 360 degrees throughout the entire elevation range with maximum number of charges without support legs. But arguably, its best features are what it calls Shoot and Scoot 2.0 and its ability to fire upon moving targets on land and sea. In case you're unfamiliar with the term Shoot and Scoot 2.0, it means that the RCH-155 can fire on targets while the Boxer itself is in motion. Quite impressive. Maybe at this point we should clarify our position or our understanding of naming. It's our understanding that RCH-155 refers to the combination/package of the AGM and Boxer 8x8 armored vehicle only. The same AGM, again standing for Artillery Gun Module, if fitted onto any other platform such as the Piranha or Leopard, would not be considered an RCH-155. This is how we are reading the official KNDS material. As you can see from this press release about Switzerland buying the AGM for its Piranha 4 10x10s, there is no mention of RCH-155 anywhere. Additionally, the AGM, when mounted on the Ascod chassis, goes by the name Nemesis or Donner if referring to the previous Ascod-based combo. Thus, it is our suspicion that any websites and media outlets saying that Switzerland has purchased the RCH-155 are a bit off the mark, or maybe just optimizing their titles for search engines. But okay, enough of that. Moving on to more important material. Without getting too deep into the technical specifications, here are some of the key statistics of the Boxer-based RCH-155 for you. The weapon is operated by a two-person crew. The 155mm howitzer can fire more than 8 rounds per minute. Its ammo capacity is 30 fused rounds or 144 modular charges. Secondary armament is optional but can be a remote controlled weapon station, RCWS, or multi-purpose grenade launcher. Its combat weight is no more than 39 metric tons, and its dimensions are 10.5 meters long, about 3 meters wide, and 3.6 meters tall. Engine performance can be up to 600 kilowatts, or 815 horsepower with an MTU power pack. Driving speed is up to 100 kilometers an hour on a road surface, while driving range can be over 700 kilometers. Again, this figure applies to road driving. Its effective range depends on type of ammo used, but it can be up to 70 kilometers. The chart you see here shows other types of ammunition are being developed to provide even more effective range. And finally, direct fire capability is optional, and the brochure says that this can mean engagement of targets between 1,600 and 1,800 meters. So the RCH-155 looks like a pretty advanced weapon. Its main feature, the AGM, is made even more appealing for militaries as it can be mounted on other platforms beyond the Boxer, as you can see here. As we hinted at earlier, it's also being offered on the Ascot platform under the name Nemesis, while the Swiss have chosen the AGM to be mounted on their Piranha 4 10x10 vehicles. In terms of current operators, it looks like Ukraine is the only country that has an RCH-155 in its possession, although it has ordered a total of 54 of these guns, corresponding to 3 artillery battalions. In January 2025, Germany's defense minister took delivery of the first weapon and ceremoniously handed it over to Ukraine's ambassador to Germany. The first 6 systems will be delivered to Ukraine before the end of 2025. We also know that the UK and Germany intend to have the RCH-155 within their respective land forces. You may know that the UK has selected the RCH-155 to replace its old AS-90 self-propelled guns. The country has acquired the Swedish Archer as an interim self-propelled howitzer until the RCH-155 arrives. Clearly, it's a move that'll take some time. In January 2025, ArmyTechnology.com reported that Germany and the UK are co-developing the RCH-155 and have an anticipated combined order of up to 400 units. Germany is looking for 160 units, so the UK could order the other 240. Other than a few systems ordered to conduct testing, no large official orders from either country have been placed as of late September 2025. The UK government expects to begin introducing the RCH-155 from 2029. So, with so much interest and so many useful features and abilities, are there even any downsides to the RCH-155? Well, we might say that its high profile, its height, could be one drawback, perhaps making it easier to spot on the battlefield. Price has to be one of the biggest drawbacks in terms of customer appeal. It's probably one of the most, if not the most, expensive artillery system currently in production. While cost will vary depending on order size, a rough estimate put a single RCH-155 at 12 million euros, at least in 2022. Another potential drawback is that the RCH has a German level of mechanical complexity. While this complexity is what provides some of the platform's amazing features, we have to ask, how will it hold up in challenging conditions, and how easy will maintenance be? Can spare parts be acquired when needed? We'll have to ask the Ukrainians next year. And on that same note, while we're sure rigorous testing has been done to develop the RCH-155, we have to wonder how it'll hold up in the real world, in Ukraine, perhaps firing much more than during testing. Will it be battle-proven, or will some changes need to be made? And finally, a slow production rate is also something to consider, especially for countries considering the platform that may need to get in line behind the large orders placed by the UK and Germany. So, there's your introduction to the RCH-155. Its marketed capabilities certainly make it an impressive machine and weapon. With the RCH-155 being based on the Boxer platform, it is certainly appealing to existing Boxer users, while the AGM's ability to go on other platforms opens things up to other countries who may use other armored vehicles. While it would be quite exciting to one day see Lithuania acquire the RCH-155 to support its Boxer-based Vilkas IFV units, and Latvia acquire the Nemesis to support its Ascot-based IFVs named Mednieks or Hunter, it's not going to happen. That's because Lithuania is going with the Caesar Mark II wheeled self-propelled howitzer, while Latvia has selected the Archer from Sweden. Fine choices themselves, and most certainly made available on a shorter timeline than AGM-based platforms. But what do you think of the RCH-155? Paired with a weapon like Skyranger, will it guarantee battlefield superiority? Let us know your thoughts by leaving a comment.